What's up, everybody? Jason from Jason's Exotic Reptiles back at you with an awesome, epic video coming your way. Today's video is a Groveland gecko giveaway. I have tons of hooks, tongs, tweezers, hide boxes, egg incubations, water bowls. I have it all. Groveland Gecko sent me a huge care package. Thank you guys so much. And I'm going to be giving all of it away to you guys. Stay tuned to learn how to win and what I have. Let's do a review. Groveland Gecko totally outdid themselves. I've seen these guys at expos for years. I've bought plenty of hooks from them. They reached out to me on Instagram and asked if I would be interested in doing a review video. I promptly said yes, I would be happy to do a review because these are products that I purchased myself in the past and I can stand behind them. I know that the stuff is quality at a really affordable price. So with that said, I want to start showing off some of this stuff they sent me. And this stuff ranges from water bowls, these little plastic ones that are hard to tip, to these ceramic water bowls or food bowls if you guys have geckos, all the way up to jumbo hides. I have jumbo hides, I have medium hides, I have it all, and I want to dive into actually taking a look at each one of these products. First, let's talk about the hides, because this is something that is super cool. I don't actually use a lot of hides in my setups because I use racks, but I know a lot of you guys out there don't have the same setups, or you do appreciate the hides. So let's kind of take a look at some of these. The first set of hides that I'm going to review, I'm not sure what they're called, but all of this stuff is available on Groveland Gecko's website. I can't thank them enough for sending me this stuff. This is like blew my mind when I saw the box. I thought they were gonna send me a couple hooks and maybe a hide or two, but they sent me like a bunch of everything. I opened up these boxes and was like, how am I gonna give this stuff away? This is gonna cost me thousands of dollars just to ship. So what I want you guys to do is during the course of this video, take a look at what I have, and I'm gonna be putting together some packages of stuff. I'd like to put together a package of hides, hooks, tongs, egg cutting scissors. You know, if you see it, give me a package. Shoot me in the comment exactly what you want. And this is gonna be an Instagram-based giveaway. So in order to qualify for the giveaway, you need to drop your Instagram username in the comment. In my last giveaway video, I got a ton of great comments, but a bunch of you didn't put your username. I'm gonna be posting the details of the giveaway on my Instagram story. So you have to follow my Instagram to figure out if you've won. In about a week after this video posts is when I'm gonna be posting that giveaway. Without further ado, let's jump into the hides. So the first set of hides I have are these kind of like plastic cocoa hides. I think they're super cool. I'm assuming this is a small, medium, and large. So this is, I'm guessing, is the large. This is the medium, and this is the small, or this could be extra small, small, medium, but really cool little things, because the key thing about a hide is that it has to be tight and secure for your animal. A lot of people will buy a hide like this and put a tiny baby boa in it. Yes, they do get some closure from the hide itself, but really you want them to feel secure. So this kind of combo here is something that the animal could grow through and grow within, is as they're babies and hatchlings, you use this little hide here. As they start growing up, they hit a foot or two, couple feet, then you use this medium hide. And as they're older adults, something like this would be perfect for a ball python. These are also great for you lizard keepers. I could see an adult bearded dragon using this one, or maybe some geckos, you know, little adult geckos. If you have a colony of them, they use some of these. One little baby gecko, something like this one here. They're smooth and easy to disinfect. I really like that about those hides there. The next set of hides that I received, which are pretty cool if you want to add to a little bit of the aesthetic appeal to your enclosures, are these turtle shell hides. I'm assuming this is the small and this is the medium. I have a couple of these guys I'm going to give away. And again, really good sizes. This would be good for a hatchling boa, ball python, something like that. These would be good for something like a raise-up boa, ball python, or some of your lizards that you guys may be keeping. I will also mention I have some really cool venomous supplies here for you venomous keepers in the house. If you're a venomous keeper, make sure you add that in your comment. Keeping on the themes of hides, I did scroll their website and I specifically asked, I said, hey, I see you guys have some humidity hides. I have a lot of people who watch my channel who struggle with humidity because I see that in the comments. So I thought this hide, they have these in all different sizes, and we're gonna go through the sizes in a minute, but this I thought was really cool because it has this little cover here that comes off, and that's your little humidity packet, but there's a couple of them in there. There's these little perforated sections here, and then they have four of these little things that you would wet. These would stay humid, and then you would put them in these little grooves here. Let's see if I can pull them open. So these would get put in this groove, and these stay wet while increasing the humidity within the hide. So for all you people who have blood pythons or those species that are a little bit more demanding for humidity, this then gets wet. This little flap here that just kind of moves open and closed, that slaps shut, and then you have a nice little hide for this. I actually thought this was super cool. This is a good tool to have in your arsenal if you have more of this open airflow enclosure. So really cool humidity hide. And then the basic hides, which are just what we've all seen. These are the different sizes, jumbo, large, medium, small. I love these hides because they're super easy to disinfect. Disinfection is something that I am an advocate for because as reptile keepers, the cleaner we can keep our enclosures in general, the healthier our animals are gonna be, assuming all the other conditions are good. The cork bark logs are cool, but you can't really disinfect them unless you plan to soak them overnight in some bleach or something similar. So the hide sizes for this, I believe this is small. This is your medium. This is your large. And this is your jumbo. So for all you people who are looking for the different hides for different life stages of your animals, these things are perfect. If you have multiple animals, grab a size of all of them. Drop in the comments, I need to put packages of this stuff together. This is a US only giveaway. Unfortunately, I'm not gonna do international shipping for this. It would just cost me too much. Please like, share, and subscribe this video because the better this does, the easier it is for me to continue make content like this. So, different life stages. This is probably big enough to fit a small adult berm, definitely big enough to fit an adult boa. So this jumbo hide, for all you people who have been struggling to find those hides big enough for boas that are also easy to clean and disinfect and durable, will last a long time, this is one you're gonna wanna go for. Maybe your male boas, those sub-adult males, this is perfect because it's just big enough for an adult snake to fit perfectly and comfortable in here, but it will probably last them a little bit longer than something like this medium hide will. This medium hide is gonna be great for your ball pythons. Your adult males or females are probably gonna fit perfectly in this thing, and they will fit inside your racks and your cages very well. And then this small hide is gonna be great for your sub-adult and maybe your juvenile if you have a big species, maybe like a blood python or something like that, or your one-year-old Burmese pythons, boas, this one's great for it. So that brings us through the hides. The next quick one I wanna touch on, which I thought was pretty cool, is they sent me some of these little egg holders. For you people who breed pythons and colubrids and other egg-laying species of snakes, even lizards, this is like the perfect size for your monitor eggs or your ball python clutches. I thought this was really cool because instead of using the typical vermiculite or perlite or some type of incubation substrate, you could actually just put water in the bottom of a bin, put this thing on top of it so the eggs are not in physical contact with the water, and then you place your eggs gently in these little holes here. Very cool little design. I never thought about these and I'm happy they sent them. Probably gonna keep one or two of these myself just to try out and experiment with. I think water with a bin and some of these things in them just sitting nicely would probably do the trick and do me some real good. The next couple things we're gonna go to before I get into the fun stuff, which are the hooks, are gonna be your water bowls. So these are some heavy ceramic water bowls, or they could be food bowls. Something that we struggle with, or at least I struggle with often, are snakes tipping their bowls. Now these are gonna be perfect. I have a couple different sizes here. This is gonna be great for your smaller colubrids and small boas that are in the cages that can fit them as they're growing. This one is as they get a little bit larger. And then your adults, something like an adult boa, ball python, similar to that would fit really well in these. I know they make bigger bowls than this, and I wish I had all the details for you, but definitely check out their website. It's Groveland Gecko. This is the sticker and the logo. Nathaniel is who sent me all this stuff. They're at most of your Northeast US reptile shows. Really cool people, and this is just a snapshot of some of the stuff that they have here. I've used them for years. I bought all this stuff at reptile shows. So again, I was super excited to try this stuff out when they sent it to me. Totally outdid themselves. The next set of bowls, if you guys are looking for a cheaper option or something that is a little bit less fragile as those glass options, these ones here, these are kind of more typically what I like to use. What I like about this lip they have on the bottom here is it can second as a hide. And I use these often for my juvenile snakes because they can use them as both a water, and you'll see them coiled up underneath as a hide. Kind of just put them in and they'll use this interior bowl section as a hide. Just can't say enough good stuff about these people and the stuff that they supply. It's inexpensive and really good quality. Now to the fun stuff, because this is the stuff that isn't necessarily needed, but it's really cool. And some of this stuff I would highly recommend. So I'm gonna go and let's start with the feeding tongs. So I do have a couple different sizes. I believe there's also a medium-sized tong in there, but you have your basic tongs like this, which are perfect for your smaller animals when you're feeding mice and things like that. You can get close, your babies. I actually have a pair almost just like this, but it doesn't have this metallic finish. I have a whole bunch of these, so again, drop in the comments if you see something you like. Drop your Instagram username. I need that username. I will not reach out to you. So if you see a message from me, whether that be email, Instagram, whatever, it's not from me. I will not reach out to you. You guys will see me post the winners on my Instagram story, and that's when I need you to reach out to me saying, hey, you tagged me, I'm a winner, I'll collect all your info on how to ship it. This is no cost, so I will not ask you guys for money. If anybody's asking you for money, please do not respond to them. It's not me. Even if the name looks like my Instagram username, it's not me. I will not ask you for money. Back to the review. These little hemostats, I've used these a ton. I still have my first pair. I probably bought from them 10, 15 years ago. It was a long time. Maybe it wasn't 15 years, but it was a while ago. And I still use them today. They still work perfectly. The next one up are these hemostats like this tile. Now, at first, I did not like the locking mechanism. These have a little locking mechanism on there. I'll get a little closer to the camera so you can see. But it have this little click lock. Clicks in and it holds them closed. At first, I did not like these. I had the one that did not have that click lock, and I loved them until they were out of them. These are something I have probably 5 or 6 pairs just laying around the room because I'm always misplacing them. Literally, I'll be feeding a snake, I'll feed the snake, put these things down, and be looking for them for an hour. So I just grab another pair, and I'll find them later. So I have a couple pairs of these. I really like this size for your smaller to medium-sized snakes. It gives you just enough distance. I think these are about 10 or 12 inches, but just enough distance to hold the mouse, and you can hold it by its back, its tail, whatever you prefer, its feet. You can feed your animal, and you can keep a safe distance of your hand away. It's more reliable feeding results than holding the mouse by the tail. So these, highly recommend them. I've used them, I love them, and I can't get enough of them because I keep buying them. The other option, in addition to the first hemostats that I just talked about, these ones, is they have these rubber tip hemostats. I like these as well, and I actually, they gave me a couple pairs of these. I stole one for myself, because when you're feeding these baby boas or really any snake, they have a tendency to occasionally miss the hook or miss the rodent, and they end up biting the tongs. So these little rubber tip ones are awesome. One, because they're high visibility, I can find them, I don't lose them as often as the others. And then two, because if they bite the tong, they're not gonna hurt their teeth. So that's important, is keeping in mind the safety of our animals, is as these things are babies, they're a little wild and frantic when they go for the food. This is a perfect addition to these regular tongs, that it gives you a little extra grip, but it also prevents damage to the snake's teeth. I just took another look through the boxes, and I don't believe I have medium-sized ones, but these, I want to say, are their 24-inch tongs. Now, I've never actually tried these myself, and they sent me a couple pairs. I'm going to use one because I want to see how they work. This is excellent, especially for you venomous keepers out there who are still feeding small rodents. I typically haven't used these because in the past, I like these. They give me a nice grip on the animal, and it has a trigger action. Let me take this elastic off. Has a nice trigger action on the tong end of this. So I like these because it gives me a good strong grip. But for those of you who prefer a hemostat based, you can click it in, lock it, and you venomous keepers can keep your safe distance away from all these animals. This also works really well as you have growing snakes that have quite a bit more strike range. Now, I usually don't have any issue even feeding large snakes with this because I know where their strike range is. But if you're not comfortable fully understanding the strike range of the snake, I highly recommend getting tongs that are a little bit larger than smaller. They will protect you, they will protect the animal. The last thing anybody wants is you or the animal to get bit, and then all of a sudden you have to go to the hospital because you have a giant tear in your hand or you got bit by a venomous animal. Hopefully you people keeping venomous know better than that. If not, you need to get yourself some tongs like this or some hemostats like this. They do sell these tongs in all different sizes. I want to say this is their 18-inch, branded nicely, and I will promise you these last a long time. I still have pairs from years ago. This was actually one of my first purchases that I purchased, well, not necessarily from Groveland Gecko, but I have bought a handful handful of these from Groveland Gecko over the years because just like all my other tongues, I lose them. These are not for handling snakes. In my opinion, these are for feeding rodents. They give a nice grip on the end. You can pick it up, you have full control. You can support it from here if you need to, but an excellent tool to have in your arsenal. The next set of tongs, which I actually think are pretty cool, and these are more if you have venomous animals, are these guys here. Now this will also work really well for rodent feeders. It gives you this nice flat panel and you can actually hold the prey in nicely. Alternatively, you can use these for handling those more venomous animals where you need to keep your distance without hurting the snake. Hurting the snake is something we want to avoid at all costs, and having this extra pad here not only gives you grip to grip a rodent, but also grip to gently hold a snake without putting too much pressure. Where these here, these in my opinion again should only be used for feeding tongs because they put a single point of pressure. You can easily break an animal's ribs. These ones give you a wider pressure dissipation, and it also gives you this little lip here that will prevent anything from escaping. So these are really good for handling your venomous animals as well as prey. I should also mention that all of this stuff, or most of this stuff, comes in an array of different colors. This is a red one and a black one. They have blue, they have green, they have these metallic colors, they have pink. Any color you want, they probably have it. So really cool stuff. Now, let's dive into the hooks. Hooks are my thing. For some reason, I, as a reptile keeper, one of my first purchases was a reptile hook. I think that this is an essential tool to have if you are a reptile keeper, is you need to have a good hook. This will help in tap training your animals, as well as help in keeping you safe and keep a nice distance away. As you're pulling eggs, as you're maneuvering a snake, as you're cleaning their cage, whatever it might be, it's always good to have a hook on hand. I have them all around my room for myself and my guys. As we're cleaning, I probably have 10 hooks around my room right now, ranging in size from the little itty bitty ones like this, if you just need to give the snake a nudge and get them away from you, all the way up to 4-foot hooks that are much larger than this. If you got a snake that's coming at you like crazy, you can keep a safe distance. Now, in looking at these hooks, we'll go from size small to large. This is an excellent little hook. We don't need this giant hook where you're 5 feet away. I like these small hooks even for large snakes because it allows me to just give a little bit extra distance away from my snake, wake them up, move them over a little bit. You're not doing anything too invasive, but this also works great for babies. You have to remember that the longer the hook you have, the less control you have over the end. So this thing I use as an extension of my arm, just pushing their head out of the way so I can gently get in and get into cleaning the cages. If you want something that's a little bit bigger, they have something like this. They actually have, I believe, a medium size. I want to say this is their 18 inch, maybe their 24 inch. I believe they have a medium size to this as well. But this hook is an excellent tool as well because it's still small. Hooks are not meant to pick animals up unless you're a venomous keeper. In that case, you should know how to do this. I'm not going to get into venomous keeping and how to handle venomous animals, but I think this size hook is also perfect because you can use these on large snakes and baby snakes if you choke up on the grip a little bit. So it gives you that extra advantage to be able to use it on multiple animals. Somebody like myself, I have these laying in my baby racks. They're just kind of sitting there on the shelf. Something like this, I'll keep my hooks like that. At first, I used to buy all black, but as I've gotten a little bit further in my snake keeping, I now start buying these brighter colors or these metallic colors. I just had one, it's in my hand. These metallic colors, because they stand out a little bit more. If you take a black hook and you put it on your rack like this, or you put it on the top of your cage, you're probably gonna lose it quickly. So I like the more highlighted bright colors. I have a whole box of these things, literally a box of hooks like this in all different sizes. So you tell me what you guys are interested in and why, and I'll consider that a comment, and I'm gonna put together a nice package for you. The next hook that I enjoy, and I thought was really cool and unique, was this one. Now, I didn't see myself ever using something like this, but I thought the versatility of having a hook on one side and something to pin an animal on the other was really cool. I just used it to identify whether I had male or female Burmese pythons, and it's really gentle. I was able to pin the back of their head, gently pick them up, and keep them calm the whole way so that when I actually rolled their tails and popped them, I was not getting bit and the animal didn't freak out. In the past, I would have kind of picked up the animal gently let their head slide and then hold them behind the neck quickly, I was able to kind of do this gently, pin the back of their head, pick them up. This is also perfect for you venomous keepers out there who need to deal with an animal like that. You need to pin the back of their head. Really cool addition. I'm keeping this specific one myself because this is something I saw and I thought, wow, that's a really cool tool. I've never seen this. I need it. I'm gonna keep it. So I opened that one up, tried it, kept it, and I like it. I would highly recommend those, especially for you breeders who need to kind of do a little bit more manual manipulation to the animals prior to selling so you can properly identify male versus female. The next hookup are these guys here. Really perfect size. I love this size hook. I have a handful of them around. I think this is the perfect size hook for you boa keepers. It is a very heavy, sturdy hook. It has a nice wide base and neck on it so you can easily manipulate an animal. Even if you have to do a small scoop of their coil and push them out of the way, it's a perfect size. Compared to something like this, you're not gonna be scooping coils with this. There's all kinds of companies out there selling hooks. I've bought them all. I've bought everything you can imagine. I keep going back to the Groveland Gecko stuff, and this is not because they sent me a whole bunch of free stuff. I would not do a video on something and give it a positive review if I did not feel strongly that I enjoy these products and I use them myself. They are affordable. Everybody knows that I like the high-end stuff, but at the same time, these are tools and they need to last and they need to be affordable. These are excellent. They are no different than the high-end stuff that you're gonna be paying $50 to $100 for. They're half the price and they're really good quality. They've lasted me a long time. So I have a couple of those I'm gonna give away. I think I have more in the box next to me. And this one was really unique. So this is a hook. It's the same, similar size, a little bit longer. I believe these are 24 inches and this one might be a 30 inch. Why I thought this was cool is, one, it has this kind of, I think they call it a viper attachment. So for you venomous keepers out there, this is what you should be using if you're trying to handle these heavy-bodied animals. It gives you a double bracket of support, so it's a double snake hook. But what's special about this one is there's a little pin on the top, and this thing pulls out and becomes a handle. You can get different adjustments and attachments for it. So if you're one of those venomous keepers and you need to pin an animal, you can put the pinning attachment on it. I thought that was nice. If you're a big python keeper and you want to put some type of just a more L-shaped hook on it, it's on and you get all these attachments. This one's great if you just need to move the animal out of the way. And then if you just want a traditional snake hook, you go for this traditional snake hook. And this is sturdy. This isn't like those collapsible hooks. Again, I'm really tempted to keep this, but if you want it, I want to give it to you because that's the purpose of this video. I thought this was one of the most versatile hooks I've ever seen. I do believe they have them in different sizes, and I thought it was just a super cool attachment that you could easily change out and try different hooks without committing to a full-blown package of buying a hook for each one. Now, transitioning into that, we spoke about this double hook attachment on this one. I also have a fixed hook attachment. So this is if you wanted to get something a little bit larger, you're committed to using this hook head, get this one. It's a little bit less money because it doesn't have different detachable heads. It's just a fixed solid hook. This is the majority of what I have, similar to these, although I don't typically use these double heads. I think they call them a viper head, and I'm assuming it's because most people who buy these are gonna be handling larger venomous snakes. This gives extra support on their body so you don't break their ribs. They also have them in smaller sizes. For you people who have those venomous snakes that are a little bit smaller, this is a perfect hook for you. You can use them, pick them up gently, gives them something to wrap around. Really cool, and I really liked this hook because it's just something different. It's something different from our normal hooks that we have these usual L-shaped heads on. The last hook that I have a couple of them for, and I thought this was very cool as well. I wasn't sure how I was gonna like it, but I would call this something like a travel or field hook, is it collapses, and it's really easy to use. So this first end is something that if you needed to use a small hook, you don't need the full distance, use the small hook head, and then to put it together, you need a little bit more distance, you get the full size hook. So for you people who are traveling, maybe if you're going backpacking, outside camping, you want to do some herping along the way, this is a cool hook because you don't need to have the whole thing. You can toss this thing in your backpack in the collapse stage. has a little carrying pouch for it, keeps it nice and tight. Or if you are using it more permanently in a snake room like I am, but you still want to have that option to bring it outdoors without carrying a giant hook around, it's like this one right here. And it's very secure. It is not like a typical collapsible hook. There's a little bit of wiggle in it, but I think these things are like 20 bucks. Short money for what they are. Maybe they're a little bit more. Go check out their website. Regardless, I really like this hook as well. I just can't say enough good things about this company and the products that they supply. The last couple gadgets that I have here are also our essentials, and those things that I usually buy as an afterthought. As I have my, let's say, my first clutch of eggs, and I'm thinking, what am I going to cut these with? For years, I use razor blades. Well, they come with all different scissors in different shapes and sizes. So here's a couple different shapes and sizes. They got some big ones, little ones, mini ones, curved ones. Whatever you think of, these things are great for cutting eggs. So this specific pair here is probably for your larger retic Burmese python eggs. And then you have your smaller colubrid eggs, something like these guys here. I actually recently used these to cut some colubrid eggs open. They're perfect. Way better than razor blades and way better than the scissors I've tried in the past. So I really enjoyed using these scissors. To that same note, I used a pair because I wanted it to try it out, and I can't put my name behind something that I haven't tried myself. Then you have these more medium-sized scissors here, a little bit of a thinner base to them, smaller compared to, let's pull open this large one. You can see the size difference in these guys here, a little bit different. I really enjoyed using these scissors when I was cutting my eggs open. One, because I wanted to try them for this video, but two, as I typically don't use scissors, I now have the pair that I used on top of my incubator, and I'm going to be using it in some upcoming videos. Some more stuff that's pretty cool. We have a temperature and humidity gauge. So this is one that comes with a wire, so you can put this in your enclosures. You can even put it in a rack like this, kind of drape this in, close it up behind it, and you can have this externally as well as it's taking the temperature internally. So I thought this was a cool little thing. I haven't pulled the battery pack. I have a handful of these I want to give away, and I think that it's just a cool little piece of an addition that you may need as you are progressing through your reptile experience. Another thing they sent me, which is very versatile, and another one of the tools that I bought as one of my earlier purchases, was they sent me a couple of these probing kits. So these guys right here, they have all different size probes. Now I would encourage you that if you are interested in one of these probe sets, know what you're doing first. You can permanently damage an animal and seriously damage an animal if you don't know what you're doing with the probe kit. Now, if you don't have a probe kit, I do think these are pretty cool. They come with all different size probes, from the little ones for the smaller snakes, all the way up to your larger ones for your bigger boas and pythons. So, very cool kit. I think these are pretty short money on their website. GrovelandGecko.com is their website. Or just search Groveland Gecko on Google, and this stuff is gonna pop up. And then the last thing I wanted to show off was these reptile snake props. So if you guys need to tube feed animals or do any veterinary procedures with them, these are really cool. They kind of wedge in between the animal's mouth and don't damage their teeth in their mouth. They have a hole down the middle. I'm gonna give these away, but I'm gonna open them up here. I actually have a set of these myself, and they've come in handy over the years. It's not something you use every day, but they certainly come in handy. They have different sizes for different snakes. You use them to prop open their mouth, and you can put a tube down the center. If you have a picky eater, if you have whatever it might be, these are really helpful, and they come in handy when you don't expect them. I'm assuming if you needed to purchase some of these, they're probably short money on their website. They're very worth having around. They're called reptile props, so you can easily examine your reptile's mouth. That's what the tag says. And that brings us through the review video. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this. If you want to enter to repeat all the details, I need this in the comments below. You need to like this video, comment below, please subscribe if you do so. I appreciate it. That's not a requirement of this, but like the video, comment below. You need to give me your Instagram username. I will not be able to track you down without that username. I can't emphasize it enough, because my last giveaway, there were almost no usernames. Great comments, no usernames. Comment down there why you want these. Tell me exactly what you want from the video in here. Put together a small package. Pick a handful of items and say, hey, I'd really like that medium-sized hide. I'd like a hook, and I'd like a water bowl. This is why I need it. And I enjoy reading the comments. So it doesn't need to be a huge paragraph of text, but tell me why you like it. Follow me on Instagram and follow Groveland Gecko on Instagram. We would both appreciate it. If you're in one of the Northeast US reptile shows, make sure to check them out. They They have all this stuff and more, super affordable prices, great people. Ask for Nathaniel Brown. Tell him Jason from Jason's Exotic Reptiles sent you. You saw his review video and you wanted to check out what they have. Until next video, I appreciate you guys watching and subscribing. Good luck to everybody who's gonna enter in the giveaway, and thank you all again for continued support.